Muscle growth refers to an increase in the volume and mass that occurs to our muscles after long-term strength training. As muscles are made up of many individual muscle fibers, growth can occur due to an increase in the number of muscle fibers, which is termed hyperplasia, or an increase in the size of the individual muscle fibers themselves, which is termed hypertrophy. Hyperplasia occurs by the longitudinal splitting of muscle fibers. Evidence supporting this mechanism of muscle growth is controversial, with some studies providing support and others rejecting it. Additionally, if hyperplasia does occur, it only contributes to about 5 to 10% of muscle growth. The primary mechanism of muscle growth is hypertrophy, which is the increase in size of the individual muscle fibers. It is an anabolic process, meaning the building up of muscle tissue. Additionally, hypertrophy only occurs when the rate of protein synthesis exceeds the rate of protein breakdown. It is important to note that an exercise-induced increase in muscle protein synthesis requires that all amino acids be present in the muscle. Therefore, adequate ingestion of high-quality protein prior to or following a workout is essential to optimizing muscle growth during resistance training. As I mentioned, each muscle is made up of many muscle cells called muscle fibers. Each muscle fiber contains many nuclei, termed myonuclei. Additionally, each muscle fiber is made up of many thread-like structures, called myofibrils, which can be further divided into individual segments called sarcomeres, short sections of contractile proteins that allow muscles to produce force. Resistance training-induced hypertrophy occurs due to the addition of these sarcomeres added in parallel. The process through which resistance training induces hypertrophy involves three primary steps. Firstly, the initial stimulus, secondly, molecular signaling, and lastly, muscle protein synthesis and satellite cell activation. There are three mechanisms which occur in response to resistance training that may stimulate muscle growth to occur: mechanical tension, metabolic stress, and muscle damage. Mechanical tension is defined as the overloading force to the muscle fibers that occur when lifting a heavy load. Muscle damage refers to the micro tears in the muscle fiber that occur as a result of weightlifting. Metabolic stress is a physiological response that occurs during exercise that leads to the accumulation of metabolites in our muscle cells, such as lactate, inorganic phosphate, and hydrogen ions. These stimuli are detected by our muscle fibers, and in turn activate molecular signaling pathways that increase the rate of protein synthesis. This results in an accumulation of protein inside the individual muscle fiber, which eventually translates into increased volume. Resistance training also stimulates the activation of muscle stem cells, called satellite cells. Once activated, satellite cells divide and fuse with the growing muscle fibers to donate their myonuclei to them. The reason for this is because each myonucleus of a muscle fiber controls the protein synthesis and breakdown over a specific volume of the muscle fiber, called the myonuclear domain. Therefore, as the size of the muscle fiber increases, more myonuclei are required to support protein synthesis over the larger area. However, adult muscle stem cells are unable to divide and generate more myonuclei themselves. Therefore, satellite cells are required to do so, and thus supporting the increased size and continued growth of the muscle fibers.